Why, hello there, dear listeners. My name is Larry Herbeck, Box Lives, Major Nelson. You've successfully downloaded the podcast. You've pressed play. You are now in for some amount of time of gaming goodness. As you've probably figured out, this is show number 592. I'm here with Laura. Hi there, Laura.
Hello.
Nice to see you, as always.
You too.
Sitting across from you is Jeffrey.
It's been too long,
Hi,
sir.
Jeffrey. We're back. We're back in the studio. You know, we have this
You're going to say back in the saddle again, and then you're going to do a whole guitar solo?
No, it's just we're back in the studio, which just feels good. You know, we have a dedicated studio that I negotiated for this, because this show's so big.
It's a nice studio.
It is, isn't it? Soundproof. It has all these speakers that I don't even know what they do.
Exactly. Security's a bit lax.
Security, well, no, it isn't. Security's very tight. I couldn't even get in here. So anyway, we're happy that you could join us. It's we love spending the time with you, and hopefully you enjoy spending it with us.
I hope so too.
This is like I have many highlights to the week, and this is one of them. It's one of the few times I get to see you, Laura, and Jeff, actually, one of the few times I get to see you as well.
It's one of the few times I look you in the eye.
That's right.
And
that's,
talk to you about games.
That's right.
Yep. I don't know.
We jump right in. I mean, it's been a busy couple weeks. On the last show, we had Graham.
It's always
delightful to have him.
It is.
Although somebody on Twitter said I was mispronouncing his name.
Really?
Do they think it's Graham?
I don't know.
Or Grammy?
I don't know. I used to call him Grammy. Yeah. Graham, if I have been mispronouncing it, why haven't you corrected me?
He's too polite to correct.
Yeah, he is. He's way too polite. But we're here. We're going to talk about what we're playing. Halo Wars 2 is out. It's a great Xbox Play Anywhere title. It's. I know Laura's playing it. Mm-hmm. Jeff is playing it. Mm-hmm. I'm playing it. You guys are all playing it, I'm sure. So we've got that. We're playing a bunch of stuff. We're going to hop right into it. By the way, before we get going, Laura.
Yeah.
Do you know what happened? Let's see, when we're recording, I think earlier this week.
What happened?
Mini Metro had an update.
It did?
Yeah,
New cities?
For iOS. I think they did some music to it and some other things. I don't know. I was reading, a lot of developers are getting lazy and it's just bug fixes, right?
Yeah, they're not listing out
like they used to be.
In their change
you just life. Throw the lazy devs trope out there, Larry.
No, Laura.
I blame the marketing.
Back me
people.
Up on this.
No. I mean, when I...
You're on your own.
Though, when I would update my own app, I would take a lot of care in that text.
Do you know, she used to do an app, Jeffrey.
I did.
I know. Yeah. I played it.
Oh, good. You played it.
When's it coming back? We're talking nerd trivia.
Don't ask me.
You started it.
I know, right?
You started it.
I get that question all the time on Twitter. When's nerd trivia coming back? And I have no ETA. My life has gotten so crazy. And it takes a lot of effort to maintain it.
Okay.
So
just do what everybody else does.
What's that?
Kickstarter.
That'd be great if I didn't have to have a full-time job. Then
right.
I could just do that.
Right.
That'd be fantastic.
Well, we need you here. Anyway, Jeff, what are you playing? We're going to start with you.
Oh, thanks. Man, it's been a while.
Yes, it has.
It has been a while.
And so there's a long list here. One thing I wanted to talk about, we've talked about, I think, how great a year it had been in the last 6 months or so for single-player campaigns in first-person shooters. We loved Battlefield. We loved Titanfall, which I think surprised us all. And one thing I had sort of left for recently was Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. And I'd picked it up on PC, on Windows 10. And,
yep.
and at some point, I was like, I'm going to jump into this one. It is really, really good. In fact, I would say out of the Call of Duty campaigns, it was my favorite one since the original Modern Warfare. Actually, like the people in it.
You were going on and on about this campaign.
Because I really liked the cast. It had a focused cast, and you see them outside of helmets, and it wasn't just a lot of like sort of military jargon, but it really like got into, you know, what's more important, the mission or the people carrying out the mission. And it's sort of like that debate going back and forth. Do you do the right thing in terms of the mission, even if it's going to cost lives? Or anyway, it made for a very interesting story, and when certain characters, if they didn't make it through, it was just a little bit of, someone was chopping onions in the room at the time.
You really got into it.
I did.
Good
and so I think it was a really excellent game. It was very different from a lot of Call of Duties. There was side missions you could do, and I did them all, and there was like a lot of space battles, and maybe that's not what everyone's looking for in a Call of Duty title.
But you enjoyed
it. I really liked it.
You enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it quite a bit.
At Jeff Rubenstein, if you want to share your thoughts.
Yes, please do.
And I know you will.
Onions?
Yes.
Any onions that were chopped in other rooms?
Look, I liked a lot. So another shooter game that I've gotten into recently, and I think you two, you have as well, Larry, is Sniper Elite 4.
Oh, yes.
Took me Sniper Elites to get into this.
I played the last one a little bit, and then something came along, and I booted this one up last week, and I was like, let me give it a shot. No pun intended. And I started playing, and it was fun.
Yeah.
Why don't you explain what the gameplay is? Because people may not get it.
Sure. So I knew one thing about the Sniper Elite series, and that is when you line up a shot well, everything goes into, well, bullet time, if you will.
Slow-mo.
You see the bullet travel through, you know, through the countryside and then rip into like a visible anatomical man's body and what it does. So it's like, oh, you punctured a lung, or you really viscerally see what the bullet does.
It is warning. It is graphic.
It's really disgusting. It's really but it's also kind of great sometimes. And there is perhaps the best achievement I've seen so far this year, and that is for shooting the Fuhrer in the mommy daddy button down there. That's an achievement. Look.
Did you get it?
Oh, I haven't gotten that far in the game.
Okay, because I was going to say, because I think it
might be part of DLC.
All right, then you and I need to, because we're going to do, it's got co-op. Mm-hmm. And you and I have been talking about this. I think I need to stream it on Beam.
I think you should do that.
So we can do a little bit.
Well, so there's co-op, and that's what we need to get into. Anyway,
unless you'd like to play, Laura. Unless you and Jeff want to play.
I'd give it a try if I...
I know about you, I don't think you'd like it.
Is it too graphic for me?
I think you could probably turn that off. But basically, you're a lone sniper sent in behind enemy lines in Italy. It's a beautiful game.
It's World War II.
Yeah, World War II. And you're going through and taking out targets of opportunity, sabotaging things, and...
generally being a nuisance.
Yeah. And but the levels are really big. It's like a big, like sort of playground area, if you will, where... I was at that first level for almost 2 hours.
I did too.
Yeah.
And you can kind of go about it. You just have, here's your tasks. Mm-hmm. Do whatever you want. It's kind of open worldy.
Yeah.
Open world sniper game. Yeah.
And you can always get that first shot off, and then they start to be able to triangulate. So there's all sorts of ways where you can use diversions. Right. You can set traps. Maybe if you end up shooting an explosive barrel, that's going to throw people off. You can do all manner of things to sort of distract people. A couple times I was found and I had to run a little bit. I think the difference between this Sniper Elite and previous ones is that if you're caught, you do have the ability to use an SMG or a pistol and with any luck actually survive the encounter.
I thought you were going to say,
there's a cyanide pill in your teeth.
Yeah.
So I've been playing a lot of that. Playing a lot of, I started Resident Evil 7.
I've been playing that. You know I play
that. That is a scary game.
It's very scary.
How are you playing?
That is like really, all right, so. We get a lot of rain up here. Rainy night, lights off, surround sound. This was a huge mistake. I was not prepared for this.
Larry plays it the opposite as you.
Yeah, I turn up the brightness, turn on all the lights.
All the lights
outside in a park.
A sunny day.
Yeah. Well, it was so the first hour was so intense that I just needed to turn it off and play Stardew Valley for a little bit.
I don't get jump scares.
Wait, doesn't it bother you?
It doesn't bother you.
It doesn't. That whole thing doesn't, because I can always see it coming, usually. But even when it happens, it's like, okay, so they're trying to. It just, I don't know, feels formulaic to me. So
it scared the crap out of me, and I think that because the move from first person, from third person to first person, makes a huge difference, especially if you've mostly been playing RE4, 5, 6, which are very action. Mm-hmm. They're sort of like just gross action as opposed to like true horror. And this is more in the line of like. Like some of the scariest moments in gaming were in Resident Evil 1, 2, and 3. And this definitely harkens back and really ups the ante. So at some point I need to gird myself and go back and play some more.
I need to go through and play it as well. I mean, I'm probably 10 or 12. I had a really difficult time with one of the bosses. Really hard time.
Yeah, I've heard the chainsaw.
I've never thrown the controller. I threw it in this game.
Really? Oh no!
Yeah, it was that bad. It popped me over the edge. So,
is there a difficulty setting to the game that you could?
There is.
Lower.
I guess there is.
That's an option.
Yeah, I didn't. No.
Oh really?
Well,
so you throw the controller, get really angry.
Unless you're playing it at the lowest level.
Well, look, Laura. I don't know if you've even started the game, but like the first hour, you see visually, this game is stunning. Mm. Like to the point, I was playing. I had my brother and my wife were in the room watching
as
well.
It was a family affair.
Yeah. Well, they wanted to
nothing
see.
Nothing says family like RE7.
Well, and then every like 15 minutes or so, my wife out of nowhere would like jab me in the ribs, like to scare me.
Oh,
which,
that's great.
Which
that's
so RIP our family because that was not cool at all.
And, no,
I was not happy about that. But visually, like they were like, is this video? Like in the beginning scenes when you're getting your way out to the farm in Louisiana. I mean, it looks like video.
Now, I must point out, it is an Xbox Play Anywhere title.
That's right.
So your save goes between your PC version. You get the PC version or the console version, whichever one you bought. You get the other platform and it's included, and your save goes back and forth.
That's great.
So I was going back and forth, actually.
Nice. I'll have to do that. I just felt like with my laptop, if I was like 1 foot away from these abominations,
it's a different story.
I would be very scared.
Yeah, you would be. You would
more be. More so than at home.
Well, good for you.
Well, you should sit your wife down, and the two of you can pass the controller.
We don't do that in our house. She does. Yeah. She's not interested. She's like she wants me to come in and tell her the story.
Okay.
Like what I just did. Like so, tell me about the like the one you know the famous one is when she came into the room right after I finished Red Dead.
Oh yeah.
And I was weeping.
What a good ending.
You're weeping.
Oh yeah. No. She's like, what happened? She's like, it's just a video game, and so I kind of played it again so she could see. She's like, okay, I could see it. Yeah. So anyway.
Yeah. Oh, and the last game we've all been playing together, this was Games with Gold game for February, I believe, Lovers in a Dangerous Space-Time. We've been going through with three players, you can really wreck house in that game. And so we've been
You and I played that. We streamed that, didn't
we? Yeah, we did. Yeah. That's a great game. It's still good.
You know, back in the day when we all had time and we used to stream?
Yeah.
Right?
This is a jab at me?
No. Just in general. I'll make time. Laura hasn't streamed with me since.
Let's stream next week.
A long time.
With Viva Pinata?
No, not that long ago.
Wow. Yeah.
Well, I haven't had my inaugural Beam stream yet. You know, I used to stream.
We should do
Twitch
a Sniper.
We should do that with co-op Sniper Elite 4. I think that would be really fun.
Or another game that has co-op, which came out this past week. Halo Wars 2.
Yes.
That's the big title, big first party title that came out, Halo Wars 2. I did the stream last week. Did you get a chance to watch it, Laura?
No,
you didn't know.
Sorry,
I
was on.
Okay. It was really good.
Thank you for tuning in.
Of course. Comments were really nice. They like it. Phil was on.
Phil was always great. I mean, it was fun to. It was actually a really hard broadcast to do because I think I mentioned this to you, Laura. You know, in the middle of a party, and so I've got an earpiece where they're like, "Okay, you got to go to camera two. Take camera two. Go to camera two." I'm like, "And you can't hear anything because it's just this chaos. Where's the camera? You can't see it." Anyway, but it was a lot of fun. Hopefully, you guys and girls enjoyed it. That was a lot of fun there. So,
can you get it after the fact?
It is available video on demand. Jeff, can you
make
a note of that?
I'll
dig up the full shit. There's like a short version, which is a highlight reel, but then there's the long version.
Okay, it's the long version. The whole show.
An hour 20 minutes. It's pretty short because I'm used to doing 2 hours, or in the case of Gears at PAX, it was 6 hours.
This wasn't like a normal Let's Play where you're just playing. This was like a very produced and you got to see inside 343. It was really cool.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. So we did that. But anyway, Halo Wars is out this week, playing a lot of that. And Laura, you want to talk about that? Because you've been playing it, right?
I have.
You played a little bit. Yeah, so
I
let's talk
a bit about it.
We'll segue right into you then.
Sure thing. So I played a lot of Halo Wars, the original game. And if you guys are a fan of that game, you will absolutely love Halo Wars 2.
You're so much younger back then.
I was. I was a younger version of myself.
Yes, you were.
Past Laura. Mm-hmm. And if you do, remember Halo Wars, you'll know that there was like really good balancing, really good campaign. They've taken that and just made it even better in Halo Wars 2.
Right.
So I highly recommend the campaign. It is similarly just as enjoyable and fun as the original one.
Right.
They've amped it up, of course, so there's a bunch of polish they did and some of the shortcuts and motions are a bit easier. And the cutscenes, have you guys seen them?
Yeah, they're gorgeous.
They're gorgeous.
They're stunning.
They are stunning. They remind me of, almost movies.
Yeah, they are movies. Well, Blur does. I think Blur did them, and they're stunning. Jeff is actually stepping out. You going to come back and join us?
Very soon.
Okay, very soon. Apparently, he's got to jump on a call. We actually have real jobs here. This is not our only job, unfortunately, so Jeff had to jump out.
I wish it was. That'd be great.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
Just sit around and talk about games all day.
Yeah, right. Anyway, so
stunning.
Yeah.
Absolutely stunning. And I am probably 4 or 5 missions into the campaign.
Oh.
I haven't had a chance to play multiplayer yet.
I got hung up on the third mission. I got distracted by something. I don't know what it was. I think it was Sniper Elite, but I got to go back to it. But I know you love strategy games.
I love RTSs.
Right.
I'm so excited that
it's finally an
RTS.
Now you've got it. It's a Play Anywhere title.
Yes.
So you have it on your console and you have it there on your Surface.
Yep, I have it here on my Surface Book.
Yep.
And I love the fact that the save game goes between. It's just fantastic.
Yeah, it just happens.
Without any effort whatsoever.
You're just like, okay.
Just pick up where I left off.
Yeah. Which is the way it should work.
Exactly.
Right? It's the way it should work.
Easy.
Yeah.
And transparent. But I know that there's a new mode. Have you had a chance to try it out called Blitz Mode?
Yeah. Yeah, we did. I played a little bit of that. Ryan and I played a little bit of that. Jeff and I are going to play it. I'd love to play it with you if you want. Because you can't do cross-platform play, but we can certainly, I have it on my computer at home, so I'd love to do that.
Yeah, give that a try. I hear it's super fun.
Yeah.
And Yeah, like the moment hit me, like when I was in the start screen, just the music, just hearing the music again, it's that Halo music. It reminds me of all the fun times playing Halo and Halo Wars back in the day on 360.
Do you,
music is great.
Do you play with the controller when you're on your PC, or do you go mouse and keyboard?
I'm going to give it a try, mouse and keyboard, and see how that changes the game.
Okay. Yeah.
And see, because as most people know, RTS is originated on PC.
Sure.
Because of all the minute detail you have to do with controlling your troops.
Yeah.
And they really struggled on consoles because of the complications.
But they kind of did it.
But they did it, yeah. Like, Halo Wars is one of the first ones I felt like was a truly, like, wonderful game to play.
Right.
Like, super easy and just super, super amount of
fun. Yeah, the one thing I miss on the console that you can't really do is, you know, like, when you just go down to the mini-map and click in an area, boom, you're there, right? And you can't really do that on the console. Maybe they'll figure it out someday.
They do have the speed up if you move the controller, the
stick.
The stick that handles the camera movement.
Yeah.
You can hold down the left bumper
and
it will speed up.
Zoom.
So you can go faster, but of course you can't do the random access on the mini map to go to any location that you want.
Right. But it's a lot of fun. So play where there's co-op in there, there's campaign co-op.
Yes, there is.
There's the Blitz mode, which is cards. You build your decks. Did you build your card decks?
I have not yet.
Okay.
I have a bunch of decks I need to go through.
Okay.
I'm playing the campaign.
Okay.
But yeah, the campaign level I was playing last night, it was a simple level, and of course there's a bunch of bonus missions on it, and I just get so into it that, instead of spending the 15 minutes I thought I would spend on it, I keep going and, you know, keep building up the biggest army to go after
you
know, all the bonus missions, just because it's so much fun. I'm a huge fan of RTSs, so this really scratches that itch.
Yes. Yeah. Well, that's pretty much all you're playing right now, right?
And I also got a chance to play Overcooked, the game we're talking about.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, the Overcooked.
Time.
Yeah.
Multiplayer.
Yeah.
Which is, again, what we talked about last time, that it was designed to be played multiplayer.
Yeah.
And it is so much fun.
Yeah.
Multiplayer.
Yeah, that's Overcooked. I know Jeff was playing a little bit of that. I played a little bit over the holiday. That is a lot of fun.
Yeah, it sure is. All of the levels are pretty much designed to be played multiplayer and to somehow make chaos.
Yeah.
So I bet if Team Dysfunction tried to play Overcooked together,
it would be chaos to the nth degree.
Disastrous.
Yeah.
There would be some yelling and some fighting as we try and work our way through it.
It's maybe we should stream that.
Yeah, maybe we should. That would be hilarious.
You know, I have this big TV in here. I just need to bring a console in the studio.
Yeah, that'd be great.
And problem would be solved.
Yeah, and pro tip for people playing Overcooked multiplayer, try and establish what jobs each of you will do.
As any successful beforehand. Kitchen.
Yeah, as any successful kitchen beforehand.
Make sure you know your role.
Exactly. Know your role. Instead of diving into a map and it just being complete chaos, like running into each other and all trying to do the same job at the same time and nobody's cleaning the dishes.
No. They're stacking up.
It's disastrous. So try to identify what role each person will play beforehand. Do a little strategy.
Sweet.
It goes a long way.
Yes. I agree. All right, then.
And what are you playing, Larry?
Oh boy, Laura. Well, I'm still scratching the Overwatch itch. That's kind of my go-to right now for a quick multiplayer fix.
Yeah.
I was playing Typo Man. I started
Typo Man.
Typo Man. Awesome. Yeah, it's kind of like this. You're playing as a little. Your character is a type. You know, it's like an O or a T or something.
It's a character.
It's a character.
A literal character.
Yeah, a little character. The character's character. Precisely.
Alphanumeric.
So you kind of have to roll through. I've only played the first, 10, 15 minutes of it. Mm-hmm. So you kind of roll along and solve puzzles. It's a platformer.
Okay.
So playing that, Halo Wars 2, we talked about that. Checked out one game called I.O., which is kind of a puzzle game. It's an ID at Xbox game.
Oh, really?
You have to, like, you have this little character. It's a sphere, and you can, like, make them bigger or smaller to solve puzzles.
Oh, like fit in different
In different things, and like if they're bigger, they get bigger speed and so forth. Sniper Elite 4, we talked about that. GTA 5, get back into there every now and then because that's such an incredible, rich sandbox to play in. Resident Evil 7 Biohazard, we talked about that. And then the one that I keep going back to because I finally finished the game, the main game, a few weeks ago. Now I'm chewing through the DLC is The Witcher.
Oh, you're still into The Witcher?
Well, The Witcher, this DLC, and Jeff, I'm sorry he's not here. He had to step out. But this is some of the, and Laura, I've been doing this a long time, just like yourself, and Jeff has as well. This is some of the most incredible downloadable content. This is not new. This has been out for quite some time. I just haven't had a chance to get around to it. And it is just, it's mind-boggling. It is the quality, what they do with the story. I mean, it is. I mean, each one of these quests could be an episode from Game of Thrones. It's just so well written.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it's
I should really get back into that.
I'm telling you, it is.
Super enjoying it.
It is. I just love it so much. I got this, and I gotta be honest with you, I kind of got this really badass armor too, so I feel good. And I got some metal and stuff. So
how did you get that armor to do?
There's in the game, there's these Witcher armor sets. So there's whole side quests of do specific side quests. You can collect the blueprints for this Witcher armor, which are enhanced in certain ways. So I got a bunch of Witcher armor.
Can you craft armor?
Kind of. You can put runes inside of armor to kind of buff them a little bit, but you can't like make it from nothing. You can in the sense you find blueprints and you bring them to a armor and they can create it, but you can't just like, you're not rolling your own.
I see.
So if that makes sense.
So Diablo.
Yeah.
Scratch my Diablo.
Yeah, I don't know. Diablo is such a different. It's very fast paced. Mm-hmm. You know, for that. So. Anyway, so yeah, so that's what we got going on. And I'm playing that. We got a, you know, Jeff's gonna come back in a minute.
Okay. And I hope so. At least not lost.
I don't think so. So we're gonna flip things up a little bit. Normally we do his bit and we do the name of the game. So we'll just do name the game here.
Okay.
Okay.
That makes sense.
Right? Because you're here, I'm here, the listeners are here.
Yeah.
And they want to know who won.
That's true.
So why don't you go ahead? Do you have the clip ready?
I do. So let's roll the clip from last week. So that was the name of the game from last time.
Yeah.
And it was a pretty easy one. It was Resident Evil 7.
It was easy because it was scary.
Scary. You have a great evil laugh.
Yeah, I know. I can. So that means if we said the name of the game, that must mean we have a winner.
We do.
And who is that? Who is this lucky person today?
The lucky person is Randy from Madison, Wisconsin.
Ooh, it's a little chilly out there, I bet.
It sure is, I bet.
Or is it now? I don't know. With all this global warming that's going on or isn't going on, I never know.
Who knows? His gamer tag is Optimar, which is pretty cool.
Yep.
Congratulations, Randy.
Yep.
You are our winner for this week.
Yep.
And you get fabulous prizes.
What did he get? I don't know what he got.
You get a copy of Shift Happens, which is an ID'd Xbox game.
Yes, it is.
A copy of Zombie Vikings, also an ID'd Xbox game. And a copy of Warhammer Quest, also an ID'd Xbox game.
Yep.
And that's not all. He also gets a full copy of For Honor.
Yep.
Which I hear is a fantastic game that I want to try.
Little combat game. Mm-hmm. And then?
And Halo Wars 2.
Oh, we couldn't let the show go by without giving away a copy of Halo Wars 2, could
exactly.
we, Laura?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And we also have a bonus.
What? A bonus?
A bonus gift.
Okay.
Which is he gets a $50 gift certificate to Jinx.
Uh-huh.
Because they have a new collection of Halo Wars 2 products.
Oh, that's right.
But of course, you can use the gift certificate for whatever he wants.
I think we showed some of those on the show, so we're going to give you $50 to go splurge on your Halo Wars 2 stuff or Jinx stuff, whatever you want.
Exactly.
Wow.
So all kinds of crazy games.
That is an incredible prize package.
Yep, crazy game, crazy prizes.
You can win too. You know, a lot of questions, who can win? If you can hear our voices, you can win.
Exactly.
Unless you're an employee of Microsoft, Steptoe, or E. I'm verbally calling them out. Specifically calling those guys out. So
former members of the show
are not eligible. So that's right.
That's right. And super easy to enter, super easy to play.
Yep.
All you have to do is listen to the sound effects that I will play shortly, and then send us an email with what game that is.
Yeah, it could be a game. It could be it's a game.
It's a game on Xbox.
That's all you need to know.
Yeah.
So are you ready?
Yep. Let's roll the tape. So that was Name the Game for this week. Like we talked about, super easy to enter.
Yeah, I think I know what it is.
I'm sure you do.
I think I know what it is.
All you have to do is send us an email, lollipop@xbox.com, ccmajor@xbox.com. Just let us know what game that is.
Yeah.
If you want to, you can tell us your name and gamer tag.
Where you're from.
But you don't have to if you don't feel comfortable sharing.
Yeah. Or you can just tell us, hey, here's my name and information, but don't say it on the air because we'll protect your privacy.
Exactly.
We respect that. Now, don't hit us up on Twitter, please. I mean, you're welcome to say hello to us on Twitter, but that does not constitute an entry.
That's true.
We have to get an email to be considered an entry, and only one per person, please.
Yes. So good luck to all you folks out there who also want to win fabulous prizes.
Oh, Laura. Oh, Laura, 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 Laura.
Yes, Larry. Larry, Larry.
What a day. What a day.
It's
so
been
a
week.
You know, I was waiting until Jeff comes back in here, but I don't know where he is, so we'll just bust into some of the news. I want to point out, I tweeted this out, but we haven't talked about it on the show, is we're taking the show on the road.
We are.
Yeah, well, you and I and Jeffrey, we're going to PAX East for our annual PAX East outing.
Exciting.
Yeah, we're going to go. We don't know what the weather's going to be like.
It doesn't snow.
I'm going to try to see if my mom, I'm trying to get my mom to come to the podcast.
That'd be amazing.
She's like, oh, I don't want to go. So come on, Mom. I've had her on the show before. A long time.
When
I think
was that?
Before you were on, I did an interview with my mom.
What did you guys talk about?
I don't even remember because she's kind of a nerd. She was building her own PC.
Oh.
That's right.
That's awesome.
So she was telling me about that. So that's obviously where I get it from. But so I'm trying to get Mom go, my sister to go. But we're going to be out there. We're really excited about bringing the show out there. We got a couple of cool surprises, some guests. We'll have some fun stuff, right? We just want to say hello. We'd love to see you. It's Saturday. I believe it's at 1 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And I'll put a link in the show notes. Let me put a note since Jeff isn't here to write it. PAX link. We're excited about that. Are you excited about it?
I am excited. It's been a while since we've done a show.
In Boston. You and I were, do you remember what happened last year?
I remember all the years.
You and I were there.
Yes.
And Jeffrey had to join us remotely.
That's true.
Right? He was playing Dark Souls. Remember he was playing Dark Souls?
You played Dark Souls through almost the whole podcast.
Right, right, right. So that was fun. But yeah, we're going to be doing, all three of us will be there live. Looking forward to that. Walk the show floor. I know Xbox, we've got a big booth. I was talking to some of the gang that's working on the booth. We're going to be doing some cool stuff there. I think we're going to do some beam streams from there.
Sweet.
And so on and so forth. So we're doing that. If you don't have a chance, go watch the last episode, previous episode, I think it was a couple weeks ago, of This Week on Xbox, where I had some folks on from, I had Chris Charler from ID at Xbox. I had Shannon Loftus. You know Shannon.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Shannon Loftus came on to give us an update on Crackdown. We had a whole bunch of guys on to talk about some cool stuff. So you go back and take a look at that. Just talked about some of the stuff to expect in 2017 in terms of games. And that's not even the stuff we've announced. If you want to hear more about that, go watch the interview I did with Phil Spencer at the Halo Wars 2 stream.
Yes.
Yeah, Phil's always. I'm trying to get him back on the show, but he's, do you know where he is this week?
No, where is
he? He's in Japan.
Really?
Yeah, he's going, I don't know what he's doing work over there. He's going to talk to some developers. But he's been flying around doing his Phil Spencer thing. So it was so I'm trying to get him on the show. So hopefully I'll get him on a future show before E3. Mm-hmm. We talked about that. We announced that we're doing our briefing on Sunday now.
Oh.
Yeah, that we have announced that. So the Xbox media briefing will be on the Sunday before E3. And I don't know, for some reason, the 11th is sticking in my
head. That's different, because it's usually on Monday.
That's right, as you know very well.
Yep.
Let me go back to, where is it, June? Yeah, June 11th. It will be from LA. We'll be doing it where we normally do it, the Galen Center.
Oh, very good.
And we'll have some fun there. So then the other thing is E3. The E3 organization has opened up, they're selling tickets to the public for the first time.
That's very new.
Yeah, very, very new. Mm-hmm. So that, now I'm going to be clear. I've had a lot of questions on this on Twitter and whatnot. The tickets to that do not get you into our briefing. They're two separate events.
Right.
And even tickets to the briefing don't get you into E3 because we just happen to do our briefing obviously around E3. So just want to make sure that everyone knows that we will probably have tickets to give away to fans. I can't tell you any more details other than, yeah, we probably will. Mm-hmm. But just want to be clear that just because a ticket gets you into E3 does not automatically get you into any of the briefings, not just ours, any of the briefings.
That's true.
So I can speak on behalf of all of our, fellow platform holders and publishing partners. Mm-hmm. That's not the way it works, unfortunately.
No, but if I am a listener and I'm interested in potentially getting a hold of one of these tickets you talked about, what do I do?
Well, right now you just have to follow me on Twitter.
Okay.
Because I'll be tweeting out, or if you want to follow me on Facebook, I'm Facebook. See this little guy right
Facebook?
Here? Yeah, well, see this thing right here?
I do see the thing that you're pointing at that nobody else can see.
That's the camera that I've been using to do Facebook Live. It's all it does is it does Facebook Live streams.
What's it called?
It's called a Mevo.
Mevo. And now you've changed it. It's standing on a stand.
It has its own.
Instead of on a pile of boxes.
Well, yeah, it's supposed to be a tripod. But this is the thing that if you go watch the video on my Facebook, on the Major Nelson Facebook page, it actually was doing some weird tracking and it was like following somebody up in the corner.
It was creepy.
It was very creepy. So anyway, so you should go check that out. But yeah, I want to make sure that if you want some tickets to E3, hopefully you can purchase them. But if you want tickets to go to the Microsoft briefing, then maybe you can win them. But I'll have details on that. In the future, we'll be doing FanFest and some other cool stuff.
Awesome.
So and you may, if you had good ears, you probably heard Jeffrey come back into the room. Hi, Jeff.
Hi.
Welcome back.
Hold on. I got to turn your microphone up because you were so loud out there.
Oh, was I really?
Oh, dude. Yeah.
Sorry.
You,
this is not a soundproof room.
That's exactly what Laura and I said. It was a spirited conversation you were having.
Yes, that's a good way of putting it.
But we already did name the game, so I figured we roll right back into the releases we talked about. We're going to be at PAX.
Yes, we are.
You know, just to kind of go over quickly again, Laura's going to join us. You'll be there. We're talking about your last time you played Dark Souls.
You weren't paying attention.
Yes, you weren't paying attention.
Well, I was mostly paying attention.
Mostly,
we were dialing in from Seattle.
Yeah, you were wearing your pajamas.
That's just how I normally dress when I'm at home, Larry.
They're
called comfort clothes. do you always wear, you know, a blazer and a paisley shirt?
I have a robe.
Oh. I wasn't wearing a robe.
Oh, sorry about that, Laura.
An ascot and a smoking jacket some Courvoisier or something. Yes. Sure. Well, did you talk about news? Did you talk about
news? No, we were just getting ready for you.
I'm
we could tell by the sound of the call you were winding up out there.
I'm in. Schedule fail. Well, anyway, why don't we talk about March's Games with Gold lineup?
Yes, which was announced earlier in the week.
Yes, it was. So starting March 1st, just a few days from now, you'll be able to download Layers of Fear on Xbox One as well as Borderlands 2. I like the Borderlands.
What?
That's a good one.
Borderlands.
Is that a product announcement? Burgerlands?
Burgerlands. Look at the Burgerlands. And then on the 15th of March.
The 16th, Eyes of March.
Yes, I said that. And then I was like, oh, the 16th. Evolve will be available. And Heavy Weapon, which is like one of those first XBLA games back in the day. So those are your games with gold. I'll link out to that so you can see that. We have a video that you'll be able to see a bit more.
I did that video.
Of course you did.
I did.
Do all of the videos.
No, I just do the voiceover. I get to. It's funny because this, you know, I like doing voiceovers every now and then. I get to go into the studio and, you know, wear the big headphones. They actually have a special microphone because I requested a specific mic that they happen to have. They didn't buy it. It's this Neumann microphone, which, Laura, I know you don't know anything about microphones, but anyone listening who does, it's a pretty high end mic. So
wow,
makes me sound good. It's kind of like your setup you have here.
With a cloud lifter.
Your cloud lifter and your SM87, or is that
something? My fancy microphone that nobody else has.
Yeah, it's specific to you.
It is.
But anyway, yeah, when you walked in, Jeff, we were talking about the live streaming that I do in here once in a while with Facebook and how we should do it. We should maybe do it, we should do a show.
Yeah.
There's been an enormous request to do the show live, so we're kind of handling that request by doing it at PAX.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But we do need to, you know, I'd love to do it, beam it or Facebook it live from in here sometime. If you guys were up to that,
I'm always ready for that. Yeah, it's been a long
terrible.
Time since we've done.
We'll have to clean this room up though.
Above us?
It's terrible. No, it's just terrible lighting in here.
It is pretty bad.
It's studio like
not as bad as when we did Google Hangouts though.
Oh God, Laura, you had the worst lighting. God, I don't know what second. If you notice, I quietly stopped asking you to do Hangouts. No, we just stopped doing them.
Does anybody? Been a while.
Yeah, we haven't done them in a while.
No, we haven't.
We can do it on Beam though.
That's true.
Yeah, we should do that.
Yeah, because I can once I get my gaming PC back, I can like take all your streams in and split them together and put them on Beam or something. We'll figure that out.
All right,
we'll figure that out. Anyway, let's go through the news, Jeffrey.
Yeah, so let's talk about some upcoming games. This time of year, we're seeing a lot of indie games coming out, and I recommend you tune to this. There's a website called Major Nelson.com.
No, I don't
know.
They seem to be really focused on the releases. I don't know. Check them out. Let me know what you think. I don't know much about that site. But what I do know is a number of games have also been announced that will be coming out. So one of them, which I thought was interesting, is Ooblets, which is sort of like a farming RPG, which is very, very big night now. Very big.
Sounds
right
like
now.
That's what's the name of it?
Ooblets.
Oh, I bought one of those at IKEA once.
Just to build it?
Exactly. What I had to build it. And I had 7 parts left over. I don't know why. An ooblets.
Well, the studio that's making it has a chief napping officer. So,
can I have that role, please?
I was about
that
to say, I've already applied for it. So they describe it as having elements of Harvest Moon and Animal Crossing and Pokemon. So if that works for you.
That sounds amazing.
And yes. IKEA.
And I'm playing a lot of Stardew Valley, so this is kind of singing to me right now. That will be coming to Xbox One and Windows 10. There's no date on that yet, but it is a Double Fine Presents game, so that is a
Double,
of a
Double Fine
quality.
Presents.
I'll link to the news on that one. Also, another big indie game that will be coming this spring to Xbox is Cities Skylines.
Oh yeah,
I'm sure you've tried this one, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
So an awesome city builder that has done very well, and we have a story about how they're adapting it for Xbox and what you'd be playing on your sofa. So very much looking forward to that. And if you have a Windows phone, yes. Minecraft
Windows Phone Gang
came out for
Pocket Edition.
Now available on Windows Phone. So I thought that was worth talking about. And one other game. Big fan of the XPA games, the Xbox Play Anywhere games that, as we talked about, like Resident Evil 7, you can jump seamlessly back and forth between Windows 10 computer and Xbox One. Riptide GP Renegade. This is a long-standing series of sort of like water racers.
Yeah, hydro racer, fast, yeah.
Foil type of things. Hydro jets. That will be coming out, or that comes out the 24th. So if you're someone who, like me, likes to jump back and forth between the Xbox and the PC, Riptide GP Renegade, just the latest.
Just the latest.
In a series of XPA games.
I love that.
I do too.
I love that. Yeah. We were talking about E3 when you were stepping out on your call, talking about, you know.
Oh, you want people to start writing stories?
No, already? No. No, we're talking about you know, the fact that we moved our briefing. That's on Sunday.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
So it'll be a lot of fun because it's always that rush. It's there's something fun to start the week on a Monday, you know, with the Monday morning. Because Laura, you've been in the briefing before.
I have.
Remember when you and your sister were there? You and your sister.
My sister and I presented. It's really fun.
Were you there that year, Jeff?
Did you see us?
Actually, I did. I was in the crowd. Did a Connect call.
I did.
Right?
That's Video right.
And I don't remember if that was through Skype or not.
Video
it was
Connect.
A long time ago.
Video Connect.
It was before there was a Skype.
Was that the Beatles year?
No,
that was the year after the Beatles year.
Well, I was there for both of those. When I was the quote-unquote Sony spy. It's well-known fact. There's always folks they're invited.
Absolutely.
And I remember...
It's a detente.
Yeah, because I remember, you know, sending invites to you
and
Aaron Greenberg to come to ours, and we gave you good seats.
Yeah, always. I remember I went to the one in Culver City.
Oh, yeah, I remember that one. That was my first E3. That's before I even worked there at Sony Pictures Studios.
Yep.
I remember looking around for Alex Trebek's parking spot. I found Pat Sajak's one time.
Well, that one I just remember coming on because I'd been onto the lots quite a few times, and I hadn't been in that. Because lots are huge coming to different angles. Mm-hmm. I hadn't been in the way you brought us in. And Laura, you're going onto the, and I'm sure it's still the same, because it used to be, I believe, MGM Studios or something.
It's before my...
Way before. No. Yeah. Well, you drive in, and right there is Tara from Gone with the Wind, the house.
Wow.
Like right off the... This was back in the day. I'm sure it's still there. But so I was like, it just shows you how, you know, with the proper framing and the right angle, anything can be anything.
Anything can be anything.
So, but anyway, yeah. So we've got E3 coming up. We'll do that on Sunday. Yeah. We'd love to have you there, Jeff.
Thank you. I'll see what I can do.
As a non-spy this time.
It is nice coming and being invited. Actually, I remember there was one year.
Yes.
Where... And it might have been the Beatles year, where when the Xbox 360S was announced, and it was like, everyone in the crowd's getting
one. That was my year.
That was your year. Yeah. Okay. So it was in some theater downtown in L.A.
Yeah, it was.
The Wiltern.
Yeah.
Yes. And it's a smaller theater.
And I came down out of the theater, and I run into you, and I'm like, Larry, where's my Xbox? I want it now. And I was just joking. I was just, you know. Giving you a little house, and you were busy because, of course, you're never busier really in a year than right after the briefing. You're like, do you really need it now? I can do it if I need to. And I was like, Larry, do your thing. Where I was like, that was touching.
I care.
I still have that Xbox.
Well, that was Laura, to your point, that was the year we unveiled it. And if you remember correctly, do you remember how we unveiled it?
I do remember.
Because that was, I don't know if I can get, I came up with the idea. I don't know if somebody else did in addition to me.
Because it was a good idea.
Because it was inside the original 360.
So Don Matrick came to the middle of the stage and then lifted.
Because it was there the whole time.
It was there the whole time.
Right.
But inside of it unbeknownst to the entire crowd,
was
the
Xbox 360.
Yes. Yeah. So you just lifted the shell of the
and it was original 360
and the Xbox 360.
I remember that.
And then you get a console. And you get a console.
Was that like 2009 or
2010?
2010. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it's funny because I remember we were talking about the Beatles being at it. And I remember because, Laura, do you remember that one? Because Laura had, was that your first
okay. E3.
And I remember you coming down. I said, I'll get you seats. And I remember I told you where to sit.
Yes, you did.
And I said, I need you to sit here.
Get a really good view from this seat.
I said, I need you to sit right here because I had gone through the rehearsals. I knew where Yoko and the Beatles, they were all going to come out on stage. Mm-hmm. And you were being a huge Beatles fan, but you didn't know.
I had no idea. I had zero idea this was going to happen.
Right.
And that is the best memory of E3 that I have.
And I remember you said, because I remember,
because
you were right on the railing.
Yes.
Right. I had you right on the railing.
Yes.
Because we did it sideways back then in the
Galen Center.
In the Galen Center. Because normally we go long ways. This was sideways. Yeah. And I parked you right in the center so you could see, you get a perfect view.
Oh, it was a fantastic seat. Yeah, so, it was perfect.
Anyway. I think I was on the top row.
Were you?
Yeah. I was last year too. I always end up, you know, near the entrance talking to people, and then it's like, oh, the lights are coming down, I should find a seat.
Right.
And then you miss the first 5 minutes of the show because you're looking walking to the upper deck.
Anyway.
Don't be like me.
We would love to have, if you want to see the Xbox E3 media briefing, we may be giving away tickets, is all I can say. So we'll just leave it at that. So I'm sorry, Jeff, we were going through the news. You were
those were your, I would recommend just because of the sheer number of releases. And I think I counted 10 ID at Xbox releases
I think I ran into Chris Charles. I think he said there was going to be 11.
Okay. Crazy amount for a 1 week
period.
Cuckoo, and there was a huge amount the week before. Something for everybody.
There is.
So I would definitely check out majornelson.com. And next week is GDC, the Game Developers Conference. We usually, and this year is one of them, we usually show off a lot of ID at Xbox games as well.
Yeah.
We'll have a number of previews and things like that on Xbox Wire, which is news.xbox.com.
Yep.
So I'd keep an eye on that site all next week.
There you go. Lots of stuff. You going down to GDC?
Not this year.
I'm not, but I may have to go down for something that I can't talk about yet. So there was email coming in while we're recording here about wanting to request for my presence.
I always love to go to SF if you need someone to show you around, all the sites.
Last time we went down there, we kind of went in your old stomping ground.
We did. We walked around the
mission. We had ice cream.
We had a heck of a burrito.
It was like the size of my forearm.
Yeah, that's how it's done.
Have
you ever heard the term mission style burritos?
No.
This is the mission.
This is the mission.
You were supposed to say yes. I just kept barreling right on. Yes, of course I've heard of mission style burritos.
Why, who hasn't?
Yes, but this is the mission.
I will let you know.
Finish it. I will.
Although there's
it's a mission you shouldn't undertake.
Well done, Laura. I like what you did there. A little wordplay. Smart. Yeah. I'll keep her around. So that GDC is coming up, Game Developer Conference, and then after that we will swing right over to PAX.
To PAX.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's gonna be a good time.
It's gonna be busy week. Hopefully the weather will behave. I know I talked to my sister this week. It's like 50 degrees out there.
I'll take that in New England.
So yeah, it's crazy weather going on. All right, we've got what else we have to go over? Because otherwise, we're gonna wrap things up here so you guys can get back to your day jobs,
which encroach occasionally on this.
Well, as we talked with that phone call.
Yeah, sorry about that.
No, look, things happen. We're gonna play some Sniper Elite. You know, we mentioned this off the air. We should stream it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you beam one side, I beam the other side.
Yeah, it would be my first beam, and I want you to be there.
Now, do you have it in your at home, right? You're in the preview program?
Of course I'm in the preview program.
Laura, are you in the preview
Xbox
program?
Xbox Insider program.
Yes, that's right, the Xbox Insider.
I'm an insider.
Program.
Yeah.
XP edition. Oh, professional, yeah. I don't know.
One of those names.
Something like that, but we appreciate everybody out there. We're working on some cool, we got some great cool features coming for the next release that some people are testing out right now. Mm-hmm. One button guide, mm-hmm. beam streaming, and a few other cool nifty things.
Oh yeah, can't wait till everyone gets that. I love me some one button guide.
Do you? Isn't that nice?
Yeah.
There's some other cool stuff that I'm working on with the team that I can't talk about yet. I spent most of the day over there saying, wouldn't it be cool if we did this? And they always roll their eyes when I say that.
And then 6 months later, it's there.
Well, it's not 6 months. Sometimes
maybe not
12
even.
Months.
Yeah, I don't
actually,
know.
One of the ideas that I've been requesting for a long time is coming in a future update. There's your headline, okay? Clickbaiters, there's your headline. Can't say what it is.
We're really flirting with this. Yeah, I know. The razor's edge.
Just going right up to the edge, and I'm just kind of tapping the tiger, pulling the tiger's tail.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to wrap it up. Thank you for coming by, Laura.
Thank you for having me.
It's kind of a crazy show there. We flipped it around. We put name the game at the top and news at the bottom. We usually flip it around
and reversed it. Yeah.
But I appreciate you rolling with that.
Of course.
Are we doing a show next week?
It depends if I have to go to GDC.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, ideally we are. You'll be here. And like I say, if I'm not here, then we'll do a show.
And if not, it'll be PAX. It'll be in Boston.
Yeah, we're going to do it live. We'll do it live.
We'll do it live.
We're going to do it live like we always do. And we're going to love to see our fans out there. So, yeah. All right, gang, we'll talk to you guys next time. You can follow us on Twitter. You can find Laura Lollipop at?
At Laura Lollipop.
Yeah, that's how you find it.
Exactly. Real thank you for telling me that.
You can find Jeff Rubenstein.
At Jeff Rubenstein.
Just follow me and look for the, they're one of the seven people that I follow. Okay, you can't miss them.
That's probably the easier way to do it.
I still follow you, so I don't know what the verdict is. What's the protocol
did
there?
Did you get any feedback from our listeners?
No, then nobody emailed
listeners,
me.
Listeners, help.
Help. Should I, you know, do I unfollow email?
No, he had his jersey retired. Yeah, leave him in. You can't say, you know what, we don't care about John DiMaggio. I was going to say Joe DiMaggio. John DiMaggio.
Right.
Because I'm thinking of it because he's the voice of Atriox.
Right.
Yes. A.K.A. Bender and Marcus Fenix.
Right.
And many mm-hmm. other.
God, that was the strangest E3 last year. With when we did that Q&A.
Yeah.
That was so bizarre with him. Love him.
He's awesome.
Anyway. All right, gang. We'll talk to you. You can follow us. You can hit us up there. We got some Back and Pat titles before I let you go.
Yeah,
Jeff, do you have the Back and Pat titles?
Burr?
Burr? I tweeted those out on Thursday. There's some new Back and Pat titles. All you need to do is to go to my blog at majornelson.com. And at the very top, there's a backward compatibility.
There is.
And there's a whole list there of over 300 titles. But Jeff, the titles
we released. Yeah, the most recent ones are Gyromancer.
Yes.
Moondiver.
Yes.
Space Invaders Infinity Gene, which was a lot of fun.
Yes.
Yeah, those are your ones right there. And then, man, they just keep coming, don't they?
Yeah.
Every week.
Yep, and the whole list is here. So if you have a question.
It's sortable. What? Sortable.
It is sortable, yes, by lots of different filters.
Yep.
And you can also search if you want to know, is Bejeweled 2 part of the Back and Pat list?
Yeah.
All
is
you have to do is search and there it is.
There's Control F.
Control F on this page.
Control F is your friend.
And you will find.
There's also a huge FAQ down at the bottom, or is at the top, I can't remember, about, you know, hey, when is this game going to come? When can I play Black Ops? You know, I don't have the answer. All
Ops?
I have is, I don't, it's something that's, I see it on my feed. I don't know.
People are asking you for that?
Yeah, I don't know why. But anyway, all the information that I can share publicly is in that FAQ, so I highly, highly recommend you enjoy that read. So.
Yes.
All right. Absolutely. All right, gang. We'll talk to you guys next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Bye.